Students, yesterday we have studied the derivation of the equations of linear motion of a body moving with uniform acceleration, right? Today, another derivation we are going to do, that is the displacement in the nth second of the motion of a body, which is moving with the uniform acceleration, right? Uniform acceleration means constant acceleration. That means, suppose a body is traveling for a certain distance, Sn for n seconds, and Sn minus 1, right? Sn minus 1 in n minus 1 seconds. Suppose that a body takes 10 seconds to travel a distance, S10, it is called S10, right? The distance to travel to the body in 9th second, what do you call it? That is called Sn minus 1. S10 minus 1. Displacement is denoted by the letter S, right? 10 minus 1, right? Then S10 minus S9, 10 minus 1, that means S9. That is what is called the displacement of the body in the 10th second. The last second, what is the displacement of the body? For that, there is a formula we can derive. That is what is called Sn. U is the initial velocity of the body. A is the acceleration. Sn is the displacement of the body in total n seconds. And Sn minus 1 is the displacement of the body in total n minus 1 second. As I said, 10 seconds and 9 seconds. N means 10 seconds. N minus 1 means 9 seconds. Now, Sn is equal to the displacement in the nth second. Nth second means if 10 and 9 are there, then what is the displacement in the 10th, last 10th second? That is what we have to calculate. So to find the displacement in the 10th second, what we have to do? We will calculate the total displacement 10 seconds minus the total displacement 9 seconds. So the displacement in 10th second can be calculated. So here we will use with the notation, Sn is equal in place of t only you are using, right? Sn, that means in total n seconds, the what is the displacement, that is equal to ut plus half a t square. In place of t, you are using n, that is only, that is un plus half a n square. And in n minus 1, what is it? Yes, n minus 1 is equal to u into n minus 1. In place of n, you will put here n minus 1 plus half into a into, in place of n here, you will put a n minus 1 square. Right? Therefore, yes, n is equal to sn minus sn minus 1. That is equal to un this value minus this value, un plus half a n square minus this value, u into n minus 1 plus half a into n minus 1 the whole square. Very clear? And this, the brackets and other things are opened, and also this is squared. Then we will get, what we will get? Un plus half a n square minus of u into n, un minus 1 into u, that is equal to minus u, plus half a into, this is squared, that means the n square minus 2n plus 1, right? Okay, now this is done like this, that is u into n, u n plus half a n square minus u n minus u plus half a into n square, right? Again, half a into 2n, 2 cancels, that is equal to minus a plus 1 into a by 2, 1 into half a is equal to a by 2, right? Now this negative sign is taken inside, absorbed inside, then you will get un plus half a n square minus un, minus into minus plus u, minus into plus minus half a n square, minus into minus plus a n, minus into plus minus a by 2. So all the unlike terms, that means the positive and negative same quantities are cancelled. Un minus un cancel, half a n square cancel. Then what is remaining? U remains, an remains, and minus a by 2 remains. So we will get u plus an minus a by 2. From these two terms, we are taking a by 2 as common factor outside. So from an minus a by 2, when a by 2 is taken outside, then an divided by a by 2 is equal to 2n, you will get. Minus a by 2 divided by a by 2 is equal to minus 1, you will get. So this is the displacement of the body in the nth second of the motion of the body, which is moving to uniform acceleration, right? In place, in terms of T also you can write, or STth means last tth second, what is the STth? STth means displacement, the last tth second is equal to U plus A by 2 into 2t minus 1 also you can write. N and T both are taken as equal to time. So this is a very important expression you can note from this board itself, as you see that very easily you can write the notes. And this is the displacement of a body which is with uniform acceleration on the nth second of the motion of the body. So about four derivations we did. V is equal to U plus AT, S is equal to U plus half AT square, V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. And the last one is STth is equal to U plus A by 2 into 2N minus 1 or U plus A by 2 into 2T minus 1. So this relation is derived. And the next one more thing I have to teach you today is, that is this one. So that is also noted here on the board, that you can write the notes also from this board itself. That is VT graph. VT graph means velocity time graph for a uniform accelerated motion. In uniform acceleration motion, acceleration remains a constant. Right? Acceleration, why it remains a constant? Because displacement in unit time always remains a constant. Every time the displacement, the velocity, right? The velocity is changing with the time. But the change in velocity per unit time is a constant. Therefore, acceleration remains a constant. So, velocity time graph of a body moving with uniform acceleration is a straight line inclined to the time axis. So, in this case, the body is moving with already, when you watch the body has an initial velocity u. If the body has initial velocity is equal to zero, then the graph would have been started from the origin. So, this is a general situation. Body starts with an initial velocity, right? And it travels with a uniform acceleration. Then the VT graph will be a straight line inclined to the x-axis. For uniformly accelerated motion, velocity time graph is a straight line inclined to the time axis. This is time axis and this is velocity axis. Right? I will write here velocity. This is velocity. This is velocity. Am I correct? So this is the condition. So in this case, from the graph, acceleration A is equal to change in velocity by change in time. Change in velocity means, suppose at a T1, the velocity of the body is V1. At a T2 time, the velocity is equal to V2. Therefore, change in velocity is equal to V2 minus V1 divided by T2 minus T1. Right? Okay. What is V2? V2 is equal to OB2. That is OB2. What is V1? V1 is equal to OA2. This is OA. Divided, what is T2? T2 is equal to OB1. What is T1 then? That is equal to OA1. Right? This is A1. This point is A1. Right? Okay. So OB2 minus OA2. OB2 minus OA2 is equal to what's that? A2 B2. This value. The whole length minus this much is equal to this much only. That is A2 B2 divided by what is OB1 minus OA1? OB1 minus OA1 is equal to A1 B1 also we can write. Am I correct? Okay. But A2 B2, yeah, but this A2 B2 is equal to BC. A2 B2 is equal to BC. Therefore, it is given as BC or CB. Okay, CB we can write. And A1 B1 is equal to AC also we can write. That is, this value A2 B2 divided by A1 B1 is equal to CB by AC. What is CB? This one divided by AC is this one. See, if this is a triangle, this is a right angle triangle, then CB by AC. CB by AC means perpendicular base. Perpendicular base is equal to tan theta. Tan theta, everybody knows that is the slope of this straight line. Slope is equal to acceleration. So already we have proved now that the slope of the velocity time graph is equal to acceleration, right? So this is acceleration is found. Then displacement also can be found using this velocity time graph. So velocity time graph can be used to find or calculate the displacement of a body. Displacement is equal to average velocity into time, because velocity into time is equal to what is called displacement. Or velocity is equal to displacement by time. Therefore, displacement is equal to what? Velocity into time. Here the velocity is changing with the time. Though it is changing in a constant rate, but velocity is changing. When velocity is changing, we can take average velocity into time. What is average velocity? Initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2 into changing time. That is this one. This is equal to the value of V1. Everybody knows from the figure. That is V1 is equal to V1. That means this is V1. That is equal to this much only. That is equal to A1A. Because OA2 is same as A1A. A1A plus, right. What is V2 then? V2 means the whole distance. That is B1B. B1B, right? B1B means the whole distance. So OB2 is equal to B1B. B1B. Right? So V1 plus V2 into T2 minus T1. That is half into, this is V1 and this is V2. Into T2 minus T1. T2 minus T1 is equal to T2 means OB1. T1 is equal to OA1. Therefore, T2 minus T1 is equal to A1, B1. T2 minus T1 is equal to A1, B1. Okay. What is A1A? A1 is one pal. This is a trapezium, you can see. Which is a trapezium? This is A1, B1, BA. This is a trapezium. In this trapezium, A1A is one parallel side, length of one parallel side. B1B is another parallel side. So half into sum of the parallel sides into distance between A1, B1 is the distance between the two parallel, this line and this line. What is the distance between them? That is A1, B1. So half into parallel sides and distance between the parallel sides is the area of the trapezium. This is the trapezium. See the trapezium. What is that? See the figure A1, BA. This trapezium, we have found displacement is equal to average velocity into time. Average velocity into time is found as equal to half into sum of the parallel sides and perpendicular distance between the parallel sides, parallel lines. This is a parallel line. This is another parallel line. So this is the perpendicular distance. What? A1, B1 is the perpendicular distance between these. So sum of the parallel sides and the perpendicular distance between the